Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2297, Power Query to match Jane Doe to Doe, comma Jane. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I'm pretty excited. All this week, I've been recording these episodes at Ignite here in Orlando, Florida, Ignite 2019. They set up 10 podcast booths, and they let people apply, and they give you 1 hour to record a podcast. I'm already at my sixth one because my podcasts are nice and short. All right, so today, this is another how to do a lookup on the way in to Power Query. And what we have here is Evan, want to know how to match these two data sets. He has Adam Weaver, Alex Waterton, Andrew Spain, and the matching file is Bailey, Gerald. This proper case, this uppercase. Can we match these two? Yes, we can using Power Query. So what we're going to do, make both of them into tables. So Control T. Click OK. Boy, I don't know. I don't know where Adam got this data from, or Evan got this data from. Who knows? So on the table design here, we're going to call it left table. And over here, we'll make this one into a table, Control T, and we'll call this one right table. Those are horrible names, I know. They're just as bad as table one and table two, I guess, when you get right down to it. But that's the way it goes. Data from a table or range. All right, so what we have here is we have name and answer. I want to make those names into uppercase. All right, so now what I need this data over here to do on the name tab, I want to go right-click, transform, and say uppercase to convert it to uppercase like that. Also, it feels like there might be a space there at the beginning. I'm not sure. So transform and trim, just in case there was a leading space. Nope. Okay, so left table, that's great. We'll keep it that way. Home, close and load to. Close and load to, only create a connection. All right, so there we go. There's our table one. Now, with table two, I need to turn this data back around. I need first name and then last name. So we're going to split that at the comma. All right, so from table two, data from table or range, and I'll choose the name along the left-hand side, split column by delimiter. Boy, and I rave about this all the time. They figured out the delimiter's a comma. Of course they did. That's the how brilliant Power Query is. Click OK. All right, so we have name and name. Now here I can see that there is a leading space before this, so transform and trim. Trim like that. And then what we're going to do is take name two before name. All right, and I'm going to combine these two fields. So I select these two fields. It's like the first one. Control click on the second one. Add column and then merge columns. The separator is going to be a space. New column is going to be name. Yep. Click OK. All right. Now, at this point, I don't need these temporary columns anymore, so I can right-click and remove those. You know, normally you think, hey, we're losing some audit trail there, but no, we're not, because we can come over here on the right-hand side to applied steps and go back and see what anything looks like. All right, that looks good. So now, home. Close and load to, only create a connection, click OK. All right, we're now ready to actually do the merge. So, data, get data, combine queries, the merge. We're going to start from the left table, and then choose the right table, name from the left table, name from the right table. Down here it says, matches 104 of 109 rows from the first table. Uh-oh, this is the first time and it hasn't been a perfect match. So I want a full outer, all rows from both. There we are. Click OK. Here from the right table. This time we are going to have to ask for name and answer. So I could have left that checked. Use original column names as prefix. Actually, yeah, this is. I'll go with that. Click OK. All right, and so you see here that Ann Bowman was in the left table, missing from the right table. Then down at the bottom, there should be some people that were in the right table, missing from the left table. How cool is that? That would have been a VLOOKUP and then another VLOOKUP. It would have been really ugly to do that in straight Excel. And doing it in Power Query is a great, great way to go. All right, so there, that trick for Evan. Who I ran into one of my live seminars. Mr. Excel LX, the holy grail of Excel tips, that book right there. Check that out. Microsoft, because we're recording here at Ignite, they say Microsoft is giving away Microsoft Surface earbuds to our listeners to enter. Go to this URL, aka.ms/podcastsweepstakes, aka.ms/podcastsweepstakes. I'll put the URL down there in the bottom before December 15th, 2019 for a chance to win. If you like what you see here, please subscribe and ring that bell down below. The bell gets you notifications. I want to thank Microsoft for hosting me here at the Podcast Center on the floor of Microsoft Ignite. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, all right. That was it. Six podcasts. I still have 15 minutes to go, although I owe them a file. All right, so let's let me take care of that here. While we chat a little bit, this is pretty much how the Mr. Excel podcast goes. Normally, I set up the file, I record it, and then edit it, and post it for the next day or something like that. Today, it was a little bit different. This morning, I set up six files. I have those files all ready to go, so I'd just be able to go bam, bam, bam here. And now, later today, at some point, I'm gonna have to go through the process of editing these and cleaning them up. I don't do as much editing as Oz does with all the fire effects and things like that. Oz is really good about that. But I will take out the mistakes and other things